Welcome back to NASCAR Race Hub. It is now time for The Pulse with Dave Moody and time to say hello to everybody out there in Sirius XM radio land. Dave, it is absolutely impossible to ignore just how popular a Clint Bowyer win is to everybody that works in the sport. It is a huge burst of energy. How do the fans feel about it?
Exactly the same way, Shannon. They love a knucklehead, and Clint Bowyer is the official knucklehead of NASCAR. I still don't know how, he came down on a pit road at the end of that race and somehow arrived with a beer already in his hand. But people love that stuff, man. He's wild. He's crazy. He's loud. He is, as they say in the construction trades, half a bubble off center a lot of the time, and people just love it.
I didn't hear that story that he already had a beer. Maybe he got it from a fan in the stands.
I don't know where it came from. I don't know if he's got a glove compartment or a cooler in that car, but, man, he arrived fully armed.
Smart guy. Yeah. So we had a conversation a few minutes ago on Hub about who we think the third driver is right now. Obviously, Kyle and Kevin are the top two, and I think before Sunday, all of us were assuming that it was Martin Truex Jr. Now, if you had some money to put on this, would you put your money on Clint, or would you put your money on Martin?
I think right this minute I'm still going to go with Martin because he is the defending series champion. We saw what he could do last year in terms of just winning one out of every two or three stages for weeks and weeks and weeks at a time. He's not been as strong this year as he was last. I'm not sure anybody could be. I think, though, over the long haul, week after week after week, he's probably got more consistency right now than Clint Bowyer.
Okay, so let's talk about the aero package that we saw at Michigan this week in the Xfinity Series. Last week after Pocono, you said you were cautiously optimistic about what you would see. Are you thumbs up, or do you still need more info?
I need a little more info. I was wildly optimistic after practice when they were 3 and 4 and 5 wide and swapping positions. That didn't really happen in the race to a large extent. Talked to a couple of guys this week about why that was, and the bottom line is you could throw it off on the inside going into the corner and try and beat a guy to the apex, but if you didn't, he'd pinch you down and get you to lift out of the throttle a little bit, and once you lifted out of the throttle with that restrictor plate, you were going to back up to about 8th or 9th place. So the drivers that were willing to try it in practice with nothing to lose, they weren't quite so willing to try it in the race when there was a lot on the line.
We still don't know if we'll see it this year. We are hearing comments that we might hear it in the Cup Series. And Brad Keselowski grabbed that big old spoon this past weekend, and he started stirring stuff up, saying that he thought it would take away the ability for drivers to make a difference. What kind of support has he received about those comments?
Well, he's received a lot of support from his fellow drivers, from retired drivers, guys like Mark Martin and Bobby Labonte that have come out very strongly in favor of him. The fans, quite honestly, I think are torn on this, because they really liked what they saw at the All-Star race. Way better than anything they've seen at an All-Star race in a good long time. If we could roll that out every week on every one of these mile-and-a-half tracks, I think the fan base would love it. Unfortunately, these tracks are not all the same. And what worked at Charlotte did not work at Pocono. It works fairly well, but not as well as we hoped this past weekend in Michigan. It's not a one-size-fits-all world, unfortunately.
Cautiously optimistic would be a good phrase, just like you said about it going into Michigan. Iowa this weekend, the Xfinity Series plus the trucks are there. Let's focus on the Xfinity Series on Sunday. What do you expect we might see out there?
I love this weekend because the big guys are out of the way. You know, they're all sitting on a beach somewhere with a fruity drink in their hand, and they deserve the time off. They absolutely do. But it puts all the focus on the Xfinity and Truck Series. I think they'll race their guts out at Iowa. It's always been a very good track for both of those series, and I hope the fans turn out. You know, we hear a lot of people say we like these Truck and Xfinity Series races when there are no Cup guys in it. Here's your opportunity to prove it.
And it's Father's Day, so a good Father's Day gift for all those dads out there.
Absolutely so.
Thanks, Dave. We appreciate it. We'll see you next week.
Thanks, Shannon.